If all of that sounded familiar, it's probably because you remember our coverage of last year's Hill Rally, and in particular the performance of Stephanie and Rachel Simmonite, two sisters from Bradford, who made an impression on most people with their brilliant driving and rather colourful running commentary.
There, to right, what are you doing, Max? Oh, can you see?
No!
Well, having conquered the world of off-roading, the girls decided to have a crack at rallying and thought doing the RAC might be a nice idea. So we decided to follow their progress in the year leading up to the event. February and Bournemouth Pleasure Gardens provide the slightly bizarre setting for Stephanie's first excursion into rallying. Unfamiliar territory indeed. The car, the terrain, and even the co-driver, all strangers.
When Stephanie started the winter rally this morning, she said she was determined to finish. Well, 18 stages, 9.5 hours later, this is the final control, and she's made it. Oh, no, she hasn't. It's an ugly man. Sorry.
Unlike me, Stephanie made no mistakes and duly arrived at the finish in one piece.
How does that feel?
Absolutely fabulous. As soon as we passed the red border back there, we had a big sigh of relief and a hip-hip-hooray. Absolutely brilliant feeling.
While Stephanie was learning the craft of rally driving, it was time for Sister Rachel to get to grips with the mysterious world of rally navigation. Chris Wood, more normally seen occupying the passenger seat during this year's Group N Championship-winning drives, volunteered to give Rachel a crash course, no pun intended, in the co-driver's art. What with directions and symbols and maps, it's all very confusing, even when the whole process takes place in a classroom at 0 miles per hour. Aberdeen in April, yes, April, saw round two of the series and the girls reunited as a team. For Rachel, her first taste of rallying was only seconds away.
Go!
This day, left six!
The atrocious conditions meant that even experienced bods were soon in trouble. Brian Lyle came to grief on this bend, and Bob Grant's escort obviously didn't like the look of it at all and decided not to bother. Stephanie, meanwhile, was driving somewhat cautiously. Mind you, that wasn't surprising given a combination of the weather and some unusual directions coming from the passenger department.
Right, six. Sorry, left. Then I think there's a chicane. 90 left. No, sorry. Hole on the right. Too late. Followed by left two. No, that is it. Sorry. You lost. Are you lost where we are? Yeah.
By May, the Mintex Rally Championship had moved on to the Isle of Man, the quickest and potentially most dangerous round of the series. Everybody knew this would be the girls' greatest test yet, and certainly Mum looked somewhat anxious. Dad looked somewhat concerned. And even the normally ebullient co-driver seemed lost in thought.
Really nervous today. Really nervous. Yeah.
If they were worried, they had a funny way of showing it. Stephanie took to the tarmac like a duck to water, and something miraculous appeared to have happened to Rachel's co-driving technique.
Left 130, right two, and long left one over crest. Late.
Thankfully, every time the girls appeared, they were in one piece, although they'd obviously seen some casualties along the way.
Some horrendous crashes out there. First couple of stages out on the top, where it's really fast, there was this escort, number five, I don't know who it was, Cosworth, it didn't look like a car.
And with that cheerful news ringing in their ears, Mum and Dad went back out to watch.
She's here. She's here.
Oh, good.
Not here. Really did
did it.
The Manx Rally was a triumph for the girls. 44th out of 140 starters and first female team home to boot.
Well done, you really attacked that.
I am absolutely
boiling.
Boiling hot.
Okay, we're going fast then, Tess.
Sweat running. Oh, God, I'm up nearly. Sweat okay. Running down my face. Well, it's rallying, isn't it? It's what it's all about now.
Judging by these prized family snaps, the sisters have always had an inclination towards speed. No dolls and prams for these two girls.
They were perhaps tomboys, if you like. They like to drive cars and ride motorbikes and ride ponies from a very early age. With the horses, they were very, very competitive, especially Rachel. She was always determined that she was going to win. She didn't, of course, all the time, but she was very keen to win. Mm.
And do you think they've got the same sort of determination now about rallying?
Definitely, yes. Yes, definitely. It's a bit worrying sometimes. I think it was on the Courage when we were at the service and they didn't arrive and we asked what was going on and the marshal said, oh, somebody's gone off the edge and the ambulance has gone in, and they were the next car through, and I thought it was them, so I had a bit of a worrying half hour there, but anyway, they turned up and it was all right, so.
Come the summer, and the girls had their first outing in a factory car, courtesy of Peugeot and Shell, who had been so impressed by the newcomers that they took the unprecedented step of offering them a works drive.
We jumped at the chance and said, yeah, that'd be great. So we did the Dukeries, that was the first one, and got some really good experience from it. And then we went on and, well, they said we could have it for another one as long as we didn't bend it. So we didn't bend it on the Dukeries, and then we did the Quinton.
And we bent it then.
We bent it then, yes.
Well, it had to happen sooner or later. A brush with a pile of logs meant that the Peugeot service crew were not going to get a day off. While they got on with sorting out the bent suspension, Stephanie got on with explaining what went wrong to the team manager. Despite not having their own spare part, the crew were still able to replace the bent bit because a spectator gamely allowed his own domestic Peugeot 106 to be cannibalised, thus allowing the girls to continue. You need a bit of luck in rallying, and the girls seem to have plenty of it. And so, the final round of the Mintex series staged in the rain-soaked forests of Yorkshire. Naturally, the Simmonites were out in strength, with Mum systematically recording everything for posterity. Mind you, perhaps it was just as well that we were there also.
I'm useless with it. Look, all my glasses fog up and I can't see through it.
Home turf for the girls and one last big effort. The result in the Yorkshire event confirmed the girls as national ladies champions and qualified them for the RAC Rally.
This has been a real learning year this year. Everything's been so new to us. It's been new for Rachel on the maps. The two-wheel drive has been new to me, and I think we'll improve next year knowing the forest like we do now.
And do you think you made the right decision when you said you wanted to go for rallying?
Oh yes, most definitely. It's wonderful. I could do it as a full-time job. Just hope someone will pay me eventually.
Well, that may be some time off yet, but there's no doubt that Stephanie and Rachel have done amazingly well. But we all know that the real test is yet to come.